All right, here we are for round four on the play. Yeah, this hand is acceptable. It has one too many tap lands, but still has two drop into three drop, which is pretty good. So we'll keep it. I guess we'll lead with the scry land because we want to find an untapped land to curve out best. All right. Well, obviously wouldn't have done that if I had known that was on top, but I think there's an argument to be made for playing the gain life land first because we don't know what he's on yet. So like if he's playing, we might get more information about how we want to scry, but I think because what we're actually just looking for is an untapped land, it's right to play the scry land first. And it looks like he's probably playing a Sidisi Whip deck. Yeah, that looks very Sidisi Whip-ish. So he found an Opulent Palace there. And now I think we'd rather not draw more land, so we'll go ahead and fetch. And try and Rabble Master you. Again, a pretty explosive draw. I guess this is just like this is the equivalent of this in like a Jeskai or a red white deck is just Seeker into Rabble Master, which feels pretty dirty but is actually reasonably fair. The Fanatic to follow up will be nice though. So you have to imagine that he's gonna Murderous Cut Rabble Master here. Okay, double Crater's Claws. As expected, kills off that guy, and now is going to take seven here. So if he has Sidisi and hits, then that's pretty annoying because he can block both of our guys. He can block the air with the zombie and the other guy with Sidisi, and just trade Sidisi for both. Ooh, but he has a tap land. That's good for us. He could spend three mana and a Murderous Cut to kill Fanatic with the way he delved last turn. The fact that he tapped both of his lands instead of delving away his whole graveyard, which was obviously smart. And it looks like that's what's happening. Okay, or just your average everyday hero's downfall. But anyway, him going to nine is very good because we happen to have two Crater's Claws and five. We can cast them for five each, so that adds up to lethal. Oh, and doesn't even have anything good anyway. Just Wayfinder plus Caryatid. So I guess we'll just attack with air and then cast the claws. It's probably better than trying to Rabble Master and potentially giving him an extra turn to like play a creature and then play Whip and gain a bunch of life. Because this way he's just gonna have to chump block this turn and then he doesn't have enough mana to like play Whip and activate it or anything like that. The only thing is this kind of tips our hand and leaves us vulnerable to Thoughtseize, but I think he was probably going to cast Thoughtseize if he had it anyway. So I don't think that's like a huge downside to this. This also plays around Doomwake a little bit. in that if he Doomwaked us, it would kill our Elvish Mystic, and then we wouldn't be able to cast the claws for five. So we'd have to like wait to draw land. All right, that's too bad. He looks like he accidentally pinged himself off Yavimaya Coast, which is kind of awkward. And Sidisi did not hit a creature, which is also kind of awkward for him. And we hit a Stormbreath Dragon. The hits just keep on coming. Is that lethal? Yes, it is. All right. As usual, Stormbreath just kills them dead. So in this matchup, when I've played it in from the like red-white side, or from the green-red bees deck I've played, I really like Xenagos. Their deck seems to have a hard time answering Planeswalkers. Sarkhan is also a little better than Stormbreath because they lean so heavily on Murderous Cut and don't generally play that many creatures. So I just like to swap Sarkhan for Stormbreath straight up. I think Stoke is pretty bad. Boonsader is also not very good. Destructive Revelry, obviously great. I think we probably want the full three. Maybe we want to cut an Ashcloud because of Doomwake. I think Ashcloud Phoenix is just not that good in the format right now. But maybe you need it to fill out your red flying curve. And maybe we cut an Arrow of the Wild. The card matches up pretty poorly against zombie tokens. So there's that. Yeah, this looks reasonable. So let's give this a whirl. Oh wait, actually, I think we want Barrage of Boulders. Yeah, I think we definitely want that. I think it's our Hornet Queen answer as well as some other things, which means that we can't take out too many of our four power guys. So maybe we'll cut another Heir of the Wilds and. Yeah, because he definitely is going to have Drown also, which makes Heir worse. So we'll just cut. We'll cut a Rattleclaw Mystic also. Alright, let's try this.